Welcome to nonstopneuron.com, where learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. In this video, we will talk about water intake and output. First, let's talk about the intake. There are two main sources from where the body gets water. One is ingestion as liquids, like water, juice, soft drinks, etc., and water present in food. Yep, don't forget the food. The fruits, vegetables, and other food materials also have some water. Remember watermelon? They have so much water. So yes, the body gets water from that present in food too. Normally, the water intake by liquid and food combined is about 2100 milliliters per day. However, this quantity varies widely depending on the climate, habit, and physical activity. Ingestion of water is controlled by thirst centers in hypothalamus. The second source of water is synthesis inside the body during various metabolic reactions. The main source is the oxidation of foodstuff. For example, the oxidation of 1 gram of carbohydrate, protein, and fat each generates 0.6 ml, 0.4 ml, and 1.1 ml of water respectively. The total amount added by metabolic activity is about 200 milliliters per day. The total intake from all these sources is about 2300 milliliters per day. So this was about sources of water. Now let's talk about the water output. There are four routes here: skin, respiratory tract, feces, and urine. First, let's talk about the skin. Water loss from the skin occurs in two ways: by sweating through the sweat glands and by diffusion through the skin. Sweating is mostly part of the regulation of body temperature. The amount lost this way depends on physical activity, atmospheric temperature, and humidity. Normally, it's about 100 milliliters per day, but it can increase up to 2 liters per hour in hot weather or during heavy exercise. So this was about sweating. The second way in which water is lost from the skin is by diffusion. It's more like passive evaporation from all over the skin, rather than active sweating by sweat glands only. Yeah, even the people who don't have sweat glands also lose water this way. See, when you keep wet clothes in open air, they get dry by evaporation, right? Similarly, our body tissues also tend to get dry by evaporation. Normally, this loss is kept to a minimum by a cornified layer of the skin. It provides a very strong barrier against diffusion. So normally water loss this way is only about 300 to 400 milliliters per day. But in conditions like burns, this layer is destroyed. So the rate of evaporation increases and more water is lost. The water loss in severe burn can increase even up to 5 liters per day. So adequate amount of fluid must be given to such patients. So this was about water loss through the skin. Next, water loss through respiratory tract. The entire airway has a mucus coating. Just like the water on any surface evaporates, it evaporates from this mucus too. So the air in the respiratory tract gets moisturized. With breathing, this moisturized air keeps getting exhaled and new drier air keeps coming in. So evaporation from the respiratory mucus keeps happening all the time. The amount of water lost this way depends on how dry the inhaled air is. Normally water loss by this route is 300 to 400 ml per day. But in dry weather, this quantity increases. This process explains the dry feeling in the respiratory passage in cold weather. So this was about water loss through the respiratory route. The water loss with respiration and diffusion from the skin is collectively called insensible water loss. It's called insensible because we are not consciously aware of it, even though it's occurring all the time. Now the next route is loss in feces. Yes, just like how food has water, the poop also has water. The amount lost this way is about 100 ml per day. In diarrhea, this quantity increases. Nothing much for this route. Finally, we have kidneys. The remaining water from body is removed by the kidneys in the form of urine. So the amount lost this way depends on how much is the intake or output by the other routes. If intake and output by other routes are normal, the volume of urine is about 1400 ml per day. But if the intake is more or loss by other routes is less, the urine volume increases. This keeps the total intake and output equal. And if the intake is less or water loss by other routes is more, the urine volume decreases. So the water lost in urine can vary from 500 ml to 20 liters in different situations. In short, the kidneys maintain a balance between water intake and output to maintain nearly a constant level of water in the body. So these were all the routes of water intake and output. Now let's have a quick summary. The main source of water are ingested fluid and food, and synthesis during metabolic reactions. An output occurs from the skin, respiratory tract, feces, and kidneys. Kidneys make the ultimate adjustment in water output to make sure that normal level of body water is maintained all the time. That's it for this topic. For sticking with me until the end, here is the bonus point for you. Although there are many routes for water intake and output, not all are regulated for the purpose of water balance. The primary purpose of most of them is actually different from water regulation. Like, taking food is primarily concerned with getting nutrients, oxidation of foodstuff happens primarily to liberate energy, sweating is concerned with regulation of body temperature, and breathing is mainly to get oxygen and remove carbon dioxide. Thus, primary purpose of most of these activities is different, and they are regulated according to the needs of these activities. Like, increase or decrease in respiration occurs to maintain optimal level of oxygen and carbon dioxide, not the water. Only the kidneys are primarily concerned with keeping the water level constant. In fact, drinking water is also primarily concerned with water balance, but it cannot be regulated as precisely as urine excretion can be. Thus, we can say the kidneys are the most important organ in water balance. That's it for this video. If you like this video, please share it with your friends and colleagues too. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.